What's up guys, Ryan here. In this video, I want to talk to you about the Printful product sync. I want to explain what it is and why you don't necessarily have to worry if you see something like this in your orders where you see not synced. And I'm going to show you how to fix that if it should be synced. So to start, we need to understand what the Printful sync does. Now, it is essentially just removing the need for any manual intervention during the workflow of customer purchases and order is fulfilled and shipped. So what I mean by that is, actually, let me use an example. I used to dropship this pair of Reebok pumps on eBay. When an eBay customer would buy them from me for about $125 per pair, I would then go to jimmyjazz.com, a shoe website, and with coupons and cash back and whatnot, they were only costing me about $50 to $55 a pair. So I was making a nice little margin on every pair sold, and customers were honestly happy to receive them because Jimmy Jazz was the last website that actually had these in stock, and they're no longer in stock, I don't think. But anyways, I made nice money doing that. But I had to manually go in following each order, order the shoes from Jimmy Jazz, input the customer shipping information, then go back to eBay, mark it as shipped, input the tracking info. All that stuff was time consuming. With the Printful integration, we don't need to do any of that, assuming that the sync works. Now, in addition to syncing Printful with your online store, the only other requirement to make the product sync work is to use Printful's add products wizard to create new products that are then pushed from Printful to your online store via the sync. So it actually starts in Printful. When you create the product here, it will push to your store. And that way, when someone buys it from your store, Printful recognizes the product ID that is unique to Printful. Every product you create in Printful, the same way you have a store ID. And if you didn't know that, next time you click your Printful store, look at the URL. You should see a string of like 7 or 8 numbers. That's your store ID. That's a unique ID or identifier for your store. The same way that each store has a unique ID, every product you create has a unique ID. And the way the sync works is Printful recognizes, because obviously the Printful sync allows it to, you know, run automated checks throughout the day to see if you got new orders. If it sees a new order and it recognizes the product ID, it will fulfill the order, ship it to your customer, input tracking. It's all done on autopilot, which is why print on demand is truly passive income outside of creating the initial listing, which, I mean, I'm creating listings all day. It once you're used to it, it takes no time. So when you got it all working, it tends to look something like this. You have all your orders fulfilled, no problems. It says waiting for fulfillment. Then it moves into fulfilling, and then it moves into fulfilled. So that's when everything is working the way it's supposed to. But every now and then you're going to see something like this, not synced. All right. You may see not synced. You may see failed. All right, there's a difference between not synced and failed. When you see failed, that means that Printful recognizes the product, but something went wrong. So when you see that, you need to go in and do manual intervention to fix it. What I do is I set a weekly calendar reminder that goes off once a week, and I go and I look at my Printful orders, and you can actually hit a dropdown and sort by failed. And if you don't see failed there, you're good to go. You don't have anything that's in that status. But if you do, you need to fix it. And the reason you should probably do that is because if you miss an order that's failed, your customer is going to hit you up in like a month and say, hey, where's my product, and leave negative feedback. So don't do that. If you see not synced, this could be, it could be okay or it could be bad. It could be okay in that you can use multiple print on demand production partners. So you can use Printful and Gearbubble at the same time. You can use Printful, Gearbubble, and Printify at the same time. It's really up to you. If you receive an order from a product that's that was created through Gearbubble, Printful will still see the order, but it'll say not synced. So in this case, I want to show you, maybe you don't want to work with Gearbubble anymore because they charge a monthly fee, which is one of the many reasons why I suggest using Printful. Maybe you just switched from Gearbubble to Printful. What do you do when you get an order on one of your old Gearbubble products? Well, I'm going to show you really quickly. So this is how you fix that. You click one of your orders that's not synced, and it'll pop up like this. You'll notice in this example, it's a coffee mug. And I do mention that because I have the Gearbubble lifetime integrations. Like I paid a lot of money, a couple thousand bucks, and I got lifetime integrations. I use Gearbubble to sell coffee mugs and shot glasses and pillowcases because they do a great job on those specific product types, and it's their pricing is more competitive than anybody else's I've seen. So in this case, I went to Printful. Printful sees a Gearbubble product, and I'm going to show you how you could, you know, in theory, have Printful fulfill this product by establishing a sync. So you're going to hit complete order from here, and then you're going to click sync product. Now it's going to pop up and you have some options. If you have products at Printful's warehouse, there's a warehouse tab. You can click that and select from your warehouse products. Or the default selection is synced items. This is assuming that you've already created the product, but somehow the sync broke. I had somebody email me earlier today and actually gave me the idea for this video. And they said that if you don't automatically renew your Etsy listing, then the sync breaks between Etsy and Printful, which I don't think I used to have that problem on Etsy. So that might be something new. But if you guys run into this issue, you would want to look at the synced items tab and then just go find the product that you had created already. There, you can actually type into the search bar and it'll find it pretty quickly. Or you can hit new products. And from here, you can, so this is going along with the example of, I just switched from Gearbubble, now I want to use Printful. You would go to new products in Printful, find a comparable coffee mug. I mean, typically you'd want to find the exact same, that's how it's supposed to work. But if you don't think, you know, the customer is going to notice the difference, you could probably get away with just using whatever's the closest in here. And from new products, find the similar product, upload your design. Essentially, you click next a few times the same way you would if you were creating a new product and adding it to the catalog of the website you're pushing to. And that's it. Then you're done. And then that product will be synced into the future. So you shouldn't need to go through this process again. It should automatically know, like recognize the next order for that product and fulfill it no problems. There's one more important thing that I want to explain that needs to be said as far or as it relates to how the Printful sync works. And it actually is going to relate to coffee mugs, t-shirts, which are the two most common print-on-demand products that people sell. But before I jump into that real quick, just wanted to tell you about Webull. It is an investing app that will give you a free stock just for signing up, and then another free stock when you deposit $100 worth up to $1,400. And I have heard stories of people getting stocks worth hundreds of dollars. I haven't seen someone get a $1,000 plus stock yet, but hopefully that'll be you. And there's a link in the description to Webull, by the way. All right, jumping back into this. Size matters. And I thought that was a funny little joke. If we're talking about t-shirts specifically, suppose we have a t-shirt order come in a size large with a specific design on it. And we have to go through that workflow I just showed you where we sync the new product. If we sync a black Gildan t-shirt size large with that design, then that sync will now be established moving forward. But the next time someone orders the exact same product in any size other than large, you're gonna need to go back in and reestablish the sync for that size, because each variation is its own unique product once the sync is broken. So that's something that needs to be said. When you reestablish a sync, it is on a, you know, if you guys sell on Amazon, you notice that when you push a Gildan t-shirt to Amazon, you see a different ASIN for black size small, black size large, black size medium, and then navy blue size small, navy blue size. They're all unique ASINs. Think of one ASIN in the Amazon catalog is equivalent to a different product. And it's not necessarily, because with Printful, there's a parent product ID that you can see in the URL, but then there's child IDs associated with that parent ID. So I don't know, I'm probably getting a little too technical. I am a web developer by trade prior to quitting my job. Now I just teach web development, but that's basically how it works. So I just want to make sure that that was understood in case you are wondering why you have to come back and resync a product. It may just be that it was a different variation, a different color, different size, etc. All right, so as I mentioned earlier, multiple print-on-demand production partners on one account, no problem. Just understand that they can see all of your orders, and each of these platforms will handle it differently. For instance, Gearbubble does not alert me when it sees an order come through that it doesn't recognize, because most of my orders come through Printful. Instead, Gearbubble only shows me the orders that come through Gearbubble. Printful, on the other hand, will let me know that it sees an order that it doesn't recognize. So all of these platforms, they're unique. Printify, I used to sell a couple, like maybe like 5% of my Etsy listings were through Printify, just because I wanted to learn it and speak to you guys about it from an informed perspective. Ever since my Etsy shop got closed, I don't use Printify anymore, but they also did not tell me about orders that didn't come. They didn't worry about orders that it didn't recognize, similar to Gearbubble. All right, guys, before I wrap up, just wanted to remind you, I have a dropship print on demand course, over 60 lectures, 10 modules. It'll show you how I make six figures selling print on demand each year, 2018, 2019. I'm going to do it again in 2020. I'm crushing it this month. I told you guys back in early April that I was going to, because Amazon merch was shut down. And, you know, I'm going to deliver basically when you see my numbers on my next income report. And last but not least, guys, if I can do it, so can you. Come up with a plan of action. If you do not know how to proceed, the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kind of sequential steps that need to be taken to get your print on demand business up and running, that's what I wrote this course for. It's there. If you don't need it, good on you. If you know you want to ask for help, no shame in that either. Thank you guys for watching this video till the end. Subscribe, like, and I'll see you at the next one.
Passive Income School is open. Enroll now at RyansMethod.com. Thank you.